We're here today with Pat Haden, Athletic Director of the University of Southern California. Pat, I can't thank you enough for joining me. This is a special forum for Drexel University's athletic marketing program. And I think it's fantastic with the subject of fundraising to have an athletic director of the University of Southern California joining us. Before we get into the questions, though, I think if our audience doesn't know, I'd like to tell them a little bit about you. Pat, as many probably know, was a quarterback at USC for 4 years in the 70s, two-time All-American, two-time national champion. But probably the most impressive thing about Pat is that he was a Phi Beta Kappa when he was at USC, won a Rhodes Scholar, studied in Oxford, had a professional career himself, made Pro Bowl, and needless to say, he's a treasure at the University of Southern California.
Thank you, by the way. That's no very problem. Nice.
Okay, so thank you for writing that for me. Now we can get down to the questions. Yeah. I should say we're here in Heritage Hall, which is the centerpiece building of the athletic complex of the University of South California. And as you can see, we managed to put some of our trophies in the background. Pat, now, about you. You came to the role of athletic director in a really non-traditional way after a very successful career in the private sector. Tell us a little bit about what you learned in your first year.
Well, it's an interesting job as an athletic director. I came from a job in finance. I was in a partner in a private equity firm, so I was doing fundraising, a lot of development work, but in a different type of way. But what I've learned here is at USC and most major programs in the country, incredible student athletes. We have 19 sports here now, Al. Everybody thinks primarily about football, maybe basketball, but the 17 other sports are really incredible. I mean, we have the best athletes, not in the state or the country, the best athletes in the world. I mean, we won Olympic gold medal every Olympics since 1904 and such. So that has been interesting, just learning about these other phenomenal student athletes. The other thing is the passion for the university, which kind of helps with the development piece, of course. But they call athletics the front porch of the university. And so there's a lot of people who don't necessarily know USC come to know USC through athletics. Right. So it's a great vehicle, ultimately, to get to a new donor base every year because you have new people entering the university because of athletics. So it's been an interesting first year for me. Some of the parts of the job were different than I expected, but it's been a blast.
Good. So in higher education today, fundraising is such an integral part of the responsibilities of an athletic director. What have you learned about the development profession that you can share with your audience?
Development guys are great. You've told me that, Al.
That's right.
Yeah, that's my mantra. That's development right. guys are great.
We know all the good restaurants.
That's it. In athletics, you're in a tough financial model box because of rising costs, private education, our cost of sales, if you will, if you're an accountant, continue to go up. And so we always have to feed the beast through development. And every one of our sports, other than football and basketball, you lose money. So you need to always be out on the fundraising trail and really kind of developing new revenue streams, new ways of approaching people, new ways of communicating to a younger generation who use Twitter, Facebook, all those things that you and I didn't grow up with. So we've kind of hired a number of younger people that can reach a younger audience, younger demographic. We'll still have a relationship with our old donors, we always will, but we need to really broaden that base.
Yeah. Pat, there's no question that every university, in order for it to continue its academic ascent, needs to build its endowment. I think there's been a common mistake that a lot of athletic fundraising departments have in the past maybe overlooked the importance of endowment in an athletic program. Could you tell us a little bit about why endowment is so important for an athletic department?
It is absolutely critical for us, and we're really on a campaign to endow every one of our scholarships. We have 250 scholarships. It takes about $1 million to endow a scholarship with a 5% spend rule and tuition where it is at USC. But if you don't, you end up having to cut sports. I mentioned earlier, we lose money in just about every sport except football and basketball. So in our case, we have 17 sports we can lose money on. If we can't endow all our scholarships, sooner or later, when the football team, for example, doesn't fill up the Coliseum anymore, we'll be in the same situation that a lot of public universities are in America today, in athletics at least, where they're cutting sports. So that's not where we want to go. So we have a great, great athletic heritage here. We want to keep it for the next 100 years, and to be able to do that, we're going to have to endow every one of our scholarships.
Yeah. as part of your job, how much time would you say you personally spend on fundraising, including the management of your fundraising staff?
Oh, Al, I'd say at least a third. Mm-hmm. At least a third.
Do you think that's enough?
That's a good question. I don't know. Is that enough? That's a very, very good question. Some days, obviously, is more than that. I did hire five new people with the intent that we're going to have five more bodies on the street and interesting people going out and trying to develop this base. But I'm not afraid to ask either. A lot of people don't have, if I didn't, I came in a non-conventional way, as you mentioned. I was in private equity before I got here. But I knew how to ask in fundraising before, so I don't mind people saying no. Life insurance salesman, I think I have a 10% hit rate. And that's kind of what we're looking for. I understand why people say no, but more importantly, we understand why people say yes.
Yeah, that's true. The collaboration between athletics and the central development operation, I think, is so important. Fundraising doesn't exist in a vacuum, especially in athletics. I mean, many of your top donors are donors to the university and vice versa. I think a common mistake fundraisers and either athletic directors or vice presidents for development make is they don't look at the collaboration that needs to happen. Tell us a little bit about how that's worked for you in the past year.
Well, it's been great at USC working with the Central Development Office. They've really, again, being new at this kind of development, for me, I've really relied very much on Central, really kind of telling us, really laying out a blueprint for us, in particular the new campaign that USC is embarking upon, a $6 billion campaign, that the kind of asks we need to get. You know, the $100,000 asks are one thing, but how are you going to get that pyramid to work to be able to raise $6 billion, in our case, whatever our assigned number is? So.
It's growing, incidentally.
Thanks, appreciate that. So central development really is key for us in the way we are embarking upon our assignment, if you will, in our campaign.
Yes. One final question. With all the responsibilities and demands on your time, how do you manage to maintain your single-digit handicap?
It's just moved to 10. I'm no longer single-digit. There's a lot of lot of
I'm
stuff in this new
now.
Job. Yeah, you want shots? Go see a doctor. Yeah, no, it's it'll be a challenge going forward.
Well, listen, Pat, I can't thank you enough for your time. There's no question that you are the embodiment of high standards in athletics and academics, and USC is very lucky to have you leading us at this point in our history.
Thank you. Thank you.